Hey, how's it going? Welcome back to my channel. This is Pradeep and you're watching Vlog of Note. So we're halfway through 2019 and I still have questions that haunt my mind. For example, why does Apple never let you use the word the in front of their iPhone? It's not the iPhone, it's iPhone.
And we are calling it iPhone.
Second, why does Samsung not put a space between Note and the number that follows it? It's not Note 9, it's Note 9.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my great pleasure to present the all-new Galaxy Note 9.
And third, why does Samsung have two different processors on their flagship phones? You have the Exynos version and then you have the Snapdragon version. One of them is inferior to the other. Let's get started. So let's start with the beginning with the Samsung Galaxy Note 8 and the Samsung Galaxy S8. This is in the year 2017. We have the Exynos 8895 processor with a Geekbench single core score of about 1900. Move over to 2018, we have the Samsung Galaxy Note 9 and the Samsung Galaxy S9 with an Exynos 9810 processor, a Geekbench score of about 3400. Then come to 2019, we have the Samsung Galaxy S10 Exynos version and the Samsung Galaxy S10 Snapdragon version. This is the Snapdragon 855 and the Exynos 9820. If you look at the single core Geekbench score of the Snapdragon 855 powered Samsung Galaxy S10, it scores about 3400 odd, which is not bad. But if you look at the single core Geekbench score of the Samsung Galaxy S10 powered by Exynos 9820, it has a single core score of about 4200, which is really impressive. However, for Samsung users across the world, anywhere except the US, we soon learned that the Exynos version versus the Snapdragon 855 version in a real world Bumble style speed test, the Snapdragon version was 15 seconds faster than the Exynos version. Also, we learned that because the Exynos version is an 8 nanometer process, whereas the Snapdragon version is a 7 nanometer process, the battery life efficiency on the Exynos version is actually worse. Naturally, a whole bunch of Samsung users in India were upset. Then, come to this post on GizmoChina, where they're referencing a post made by Ice Universe, a famous Samsung leakster, on this social networking site called Weibo, where he's talking about the Exynos 9825, not the 9820, coming in the latter half of 2019, hopefully to the Note 10. And then we have this tweet from Max Weinbach doing whatever Max Weinbach does in order to deduce for us that the 9825 is indeed coming to the Samsung Galaxy Note 10. And finally, we have this post on Slash Leaks, which has two model numbers, SM976V and SM976B, with the Exynos 9825 and the Snapdragon 855 and their respective Geekbench scores. However, if you look at the Geekbench scores for the single core, both of them seem to score somewhere the same as about 3500, which leads me to believe that this score is either unoptimized or probably fake. At least, Samsung users across the world, anywhere except the US, can take heart in the fact that Samsung, for the first time in 3 years, has actually changed their flagship Exynos processor between the Galaxy S series and the Galaxy Note series. So this year, in August 2019, we are going to get on the Galaxy Note 10, for the first time ever, the Exynos 9825, which is going to be awesome. That's about it for this week's episode, guys. Drop your comments down below whether you prefer the Snapdragon version or the Exynos version. Like this video, share this video with your friends, subscribe to Vlog of Note on YouTube, turn on notifications so that you never miss a video, and I will see you guys in the next one.